Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to another daily prophetic utterance to start your day. The Lord is saying today, I am the light that shines in the darkness, and in me there is no darkness at all, and darkness will never overcome my purpose. Before the worlds were formed, I existed and spoke, let there be light, and there was light. And in seeing the light, we saw that the light was good, and we separated the light from the darkness. My light came into the world, but people love darkness instead of my light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates my light and will not come into my light for fear that their deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth and comes into my light so that it may be seen plainly that what they have done has been done in the sight of me. I come to lead the blind by ways that have not been known. Along unfamiliar paths, I come to guide them. I come to turn the darkness into light before them and make the rough places smooth. These are the things I will do. I will not forsake them. Though many people are walking in darkness, they have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned, and I will rise upon my saints that carry my presence, who are living temples of my glory. Yes, I am the light of the world, and whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The night is nearly over, my children. The day is almost here. So let us put aside the deeds of darkness and put on the armor of light. For you were once walking in darkness, but now you are in my light. Therefore, live as children of the light. For while my spirit is with you in the world, you are carriers of my light within the world. My light represents all that is good, pure, true, holy, righteous, and reliable. The presence of my light makes the darkness irrelevant. No matter how dark it is, a single torch becomes the focus of our attention when seen. How much more when my light shines? It is time to shine my light in your life, for there is more darkness being exposed within this hour each day as you shine bright. So arise and shine in the midst of a fallen world. This darkness represents the depravity that is taking place of sin and evil within this fallen world. Just as darkness cannot exist in the presence of light, sin cannot exist in my presence, for I am holy. I am the light of this world that was sent to save all mankind. I did not come into this world to condemn it, but that it might be saved. My spirit was sent to lead and guide you out of darkness through conviction of sin. My light is truth and exposes whatever exists, whether it is good or bad. When you walk in both one foot of my kingdom and one in darkness, it is still darkness. For if you say you have fellowship with me in the light, but still walk in darkness, you lie and the truth is not in you. I am calling you to put aside all your sinful ways of living, for everything exposed by my light becomes visible, and everything that is illuminated becomes a light for me. Yes, I will bring to light the things hidden in the darkness within this generation and disclose the hearts of all. I am calling all out of compromise and lukewarmness as my coming is closer each day that passes. My grace is a gift given in my blood, and those who profane my sacrifice will receive themselves the judgment that is written. It is indeed my will that no man should perish. But I see all things, even the dark thoughts of men. My light will expose the darkness and consume it with fire. Come to my love while there is still time. For there is still time, while the door is soon to shut, and those who reject my true love and mercy will weep. Remember, the more you look into the intensity of the light of my word and love, the more clearly you can see in this life. It is my light that exposes darkness. It is in my light that there is divine wisdom and knowledge. It is in my light that there is holiness, joy, and peace. I am raising firebrands of my word that will be like fire shut up in their bones, that they will not be able to contain it. They will be firebrands setting the fields on fire. They will be courageous, passionate, righteous, bold as lions who have been in my presence, and they will roar the counsel of heaven to the nations and to those on their lost way. I will cause them to dig the wells of revival within each nation. They will be even more radical than from previous generations, who will push back in prayer and in the preaching of the word, will shift the demonic corrupt principalities that have plagued the nations. The scepter of my word will be in their hands, and my shield of faith in the other. And by the scepter of my kingdom and the scepter of judgment, they will also govern in the spiritual. They will prophesy my words and justice into systems of corruption and injustice, and my light will expose the darkness wherever they tread. I have not called you to be in the background unnoticed any longer, but it is my light, and I have called you to be the light on this earth, and I have called you to be seen as firebrands that will traverse this earth. And as you traverse this earth, you will leave a spark wherever you go, which will start a bushfire, which will start a forest fire, which will start a jungle fire. And I have come to you to be a shining example of what it means to follow me. I have called you to be a beacon of hope to all nations who will shine my light. Don't look with your natural eyes at your current circumstances to weigh up the impossibilities, for it is not about you or what you can do, but it's about what I can do through you if you're willing to yield yourself fully today. You may be saying, this word is not speaking to my situation directly. And I will say, yes, I want you to focus not on your pressing situation, but on the pressing situation which is upon my heart. And I want you to imagine that I have also called you to be a firebrand within this generation. Yes, even you. So step out of the shadows, step out of compromise, step out of lukewarmness, step out of insecurities and fears of what could have been, should have been, or would have been, and come into my light. Allow me to give you the strength and the power that you need, for it is not your might or power, but it is by my spirit. Allow me to do my work through you, that you may be my hands and my feet, to be my mouthpiece. Allow me to use you in ways that you could never thought possible before. For I desire to use you to do great works for me. Seek me in this hour, and I shall be found by you when you search for me with all of your heart. I love you and don't desire that any should perish. It is time for us to not only believe in me, but it is now time for you to show it in your actions also. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Hallelujah. It is time for us, dear saints, to get serious with God in this hour. According to Matthew 6, verse 22, it says, "The lamp of the body is the eye. If therefore your eye is good, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eye is bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in you is darkness, how great is that darkness?" So, and according to John 8 verse 12, it says, "Then spoke Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life." Hallelujah. And Ephesians 5 verse 11 to 14, it says this, in particular in verse 11, it says, "Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them. When anything is exposed by the light, it becomes visible, for anything that becomes visible is light." So let us look at this. Continuing in his exposition of our need to walk in the light of Christ, and please God, Paul here in this passage makes it plain that living apart from the darkness does not mean withdrawing completely from the world. Instead, walking as children of the light means not engaging in the sins of the unbelieving culture, even as we love the sinners around us. When it comes to interacting with the world, we are not forbidden from making friends with those who are still enslaved to sin. Rather, we are forbidden from acting in the ways that displease God. So interestingly, Paul explains that we are not to take merely a defensive stance against dark deeds and stay away from them. Our approach must be offensive. We are to expose the unfruitful works of darkness. The interplay in the immediate context between light and darkness helps us understand how this exposure happens. We see in verses 7 to 14, that which is hidden in the darkness can be revealed only when the light shines on it. And by walking in Christ, we shine the light of holiness upon the darkness around us, in us, and anywhere. It's just like switching on a light in the middle of the night. When we switch on the light, it expels the darkness around us. Hallelujah. So when our lives are filled with Christ, are filled with this light, and we start to minister the word, we become the light, and anyone around us will start to be affected by this light. So the light of God that shines through us both illuminates and transforms, exposes and cleanses. Those whom the light redeems become visible. And that which is visible in light, in other words, formerly dark individuals are cleaned and become lights through whom our Savior shines brightly. This is what happens at our conversion. And we continue to become even brighter lights as we, through confession and repentance, expose our sin to God and flee from it. Hallelujah. God wants us to flee from sin. Now, a lot of people, they don't like people that are street preachers, or they don't like people that expose sin, or even the term sin today, or repentance, or holiness and righteousness. They're not commonly used in most churches today, just in case it offends someone, not knowing that they are the very things that we need to keep in the light. Hallelujah. So I'm going to pray for you now. So Heavenly Father, I thank you for those that have received this word today, because this is solid food. This is a solid word the Lord was speaking to me all day about. So Heavenly Father, I pray, Lord, that you would reveal your strength to us. Lord, that we would realize that your glorious power is also within us. We are temples of the Holy Spirit. Let your power be released within our lives. Scatter our enemies, that the power of your word be displayed, and the power of men may believe, even the lost. Lord, we pray, Lord, we cover our lives and our home and our doorposts with the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, we receive deliverance through the blood of Jesus. We rebuke and break every powers of darkness against demons and every evil spirit off us this night in the name of Jesus Christ. We rebuke Satan, the accuser of the brethren. We rebuke the demons that have come against us to hinder our life in sickness and disease and curses, hexes or vexes. We break off and command all devils off of our children. Let every spirit be exposed in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, give us strength, Lord, to bring forth their destiny also. Lord, we pray that you would stir up our spirits to fight the enemy, done by speaking your word, praying and using your word to bring power and force within our prayers. And every prophetic word spoken over our life, though your word and through your children, let it be spoken. We are open to hearing what you are saying today. Let the hammer smash through the demonic strongholds, because your word is like a hammer. Your word is like a sword. Your word is like a fire. Let fire and let the sword come against every demonic stronghold today. And we pray, Lord Jesus, Lord, that you would fill each person as they come back to you in complete repentance today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire, repentance revival, as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if you've liked this, please subscribe if you haven't already, or forward it to a friend that they may be blessed. Don't forget also, we've got the up and coming fasting within the month of March, from the 13th to the 15th. So that's the 13th of the Friday, the Saturday and the Sunday. So please participate in that, because we get so many testimonies of those that want to sacrifice and seek the Lord through prayer and fasting. Hallelujah. So from my family to yours, God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you, saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.